No more.
Ah, that is a little better.
My heart is filled with love, which the cruel cherub has chosen for his cradle.
Much, much better. But why do you speak so slowly and hesitantly? Has your imagination developed rheumatism?
It is becoming too difficult.
My words have to, because of the darkness, my words have been broken to find your ear.
My words do not find the same difficulty.
They reach their point immediately, because I catch them with my heart. Besides, your words drop. That happens quickly. My words fly, and that takes longer.
They have been climbing more nimbly, however, in the last few moments.
They are getting used to this gymnastic feat.
It is true that I am talking to you from a very mountaintop.
And that if a word dropped from such a height, it would follow my heart and shatter it.
I will come down.
No, no. Let us enjoy this chance to speak to each other without seeing each other.
Without seeing each other?
Yes. Like elusive figures in a lovely dream. You see only the trailing blackness of a mantle, and I the dawn gray glimmer of a summer gown. I am merely a shadow, and you the iridescence of a pearl. You have no idea what this moment means to me, because until now, my words have passed through...
What?
Why, they have passed through... Through the bewildering emotion that a man feels when he looks upon you, or when you look at him. Yes, it seems like I am talking to you for the very first time.
First time? Never before have you spoken to me as you were speaking?
Never before, because in the darkness I dare. What am I saying? Forgive my incoherence. It is so sweet, so new to me.
So new?
Yes, I tell you these things, and you listen to me. Never in my least modest hoping did I ever hope for so much. It is because of these words and this voice of mine that you are trembling amongst the dusky branches. Yes, I feel the thrill of your hand among this blissful jasmine bough.
Yes, I tremble and weep and love you, and am yours, for you have carried me away.
Then let death come. There's but one more thing that I ask.
A kiss.
What?
You are in too great haste. Yes, I asked, but I was being too bold. Refuse it, me.
You asked no more than one?
Your modesty shrinks. I asked, but I begged. What is a kiss when all is said?
Come then and gather the supreme flower.
Go!
But now I feel as if I ought not.
Go, you donkey! Ah, what a turn of the screw to my heart. Kiss, banquet of love. And a little bit falls, even to me, here in the shadows. Yes, a little bit falls on my outstretched heart, because Roxanne kisses words spoken by me.
Christian, I am full of love.
My pardon?
Yes, until now, I have loved you for your handsome face. Isn't that silly? But now, in the darkness, I realize I love you for your soul alone.
No.
Oh, you do not understand. I love you for your handsome form. Now I love you for your handsome soul.
No, no, do not say it.
But I do say it. I do.
And if I were ugly, very ugly?
I'd still love you, even if you were grotesque.